The scene at the school in Nashville could easily have taken place when I was in high school, almost two decades earlier. It was an archetypical American night and immediately legible to me. I couldn't help but smile at the irony, given that I was in Nashville to talk with teens about technology and the changes in their lives. As I sat in the stands, I thought, the more things change, the more they seem to stay the same. And I started recalling speaking to a teen named Stan who had met in Iowa 3 years earlier. He told me to stop looking for differences. You'd actually be surprised at how little things have changed. I'm guessing a lot of the drama is the same. It's just the format's a little different. It's just changing the font and changing the background color, really. He made references to technology to remind me that technology wasn't really the thing that was changing anything at all. And it was this moment of you know, taking a step back and saying, what was this about the technology? What was this about the broader society that I was seeing? And a lot of adults kept coming to me being like, well, teenagers are so, you know, obsessed with their technology, with their devices, with their computers. They don't seem to talk to real people. And that was actually the thing that I found so intriguing, is that when you spend time with teenagers and they weren't having to deal with their parents all over the place, they were more than happy to talk with their friends. They were more than happy to hang out. But of course, the moment that parents came along, it was like, hi, I'm going to go back to talk to my friends. It might involve the device. And so I started to think about what had really created this. And I started to realize that over the last 30 years, we've seen some amazing transformations in American society that in some ways are what's driving people's engagement with technology, particularly young people.